how indeed different they can be. So let's welcome off and on stage each one of the class 9 students who are here to perform before you what they hope is something each one of you will sit back to enjoy.
Bonjour! A very warm and pleasant morning to each one of you. I'm Melvin Biju of Class 9C to welcome the beloved chairman of the school, Mr. Thomas Chanti MLA, Mrs. Tessie Joel, Administrator Mr. John Thomas, Director Susan Roy, Principal Sujada Ma'am, Cherian Sir, Vice Principal Joseph Sir, all our HODs, teachers and friends. Class 9 is all excited to present before you a multidisciplinary project which combines the values enshrined in our constitution. The French Revolution is being presented on stage in the form of a drama which will unfold before you now on stage. So, over to my friends.
I, Monsieur Franco Pierre of Class 9, will take you, esteemed members of this audience, in a time capsule to 18th century France.
The ideas of the historic French Revolution swept across continents with its rallying cry of liberty, equality, and fraternity. The Declaration of the Rights of Man and Citizen declared each citizen's right to life, freedom of speech, freedom of opinion, and equality before law as an individual's natural rights.
That is, these are inalienable rights and cannot be taken away. Friends, each one of us is born with these rights.
Now, let's sit back and watch on stage the powerful forces that announce the coming of a new age in 18th century France. And we shall be back for certain.
Particularly harsh.
We are starving. Our children go to bed hungry and crying. We artisans are suffering too. Our owners fix our wages.
They break our backs. There is a raw scarcity of food grains.
We workers are members of the third estate. We serve the lords and the clergy. Which enjoy human privileges. Mercy, my Lord, mercy. Mercy, my Lord, mercy. Mercy, mercy.
Sad, terribly sad.
In France, only the third estate paid taxes.
Now, what do we have here?
We have taxes on 1775 francs.
I am 10, a tax paid only by the peasants to the church. And I am 5, a direct tax on salt, tobacco and essential commodities.
Mon Dieu, in French society,
an interesting flashback to the feudal system and the old regime.
We are the first estate, and we are the second estate. We enjoy privileges by birth.
Reduce the harvest employers fixed wages of workers.
The population of France rose to 28 million in 1789. Livelihood was endangered.
This extreme situation was referred to in French society as subsistence crisis.
Sad! How very, very sad! How France must have suffered.
Where was the monarch, King Louis XVI, and his Austrian wife, Queen Marie Antoinette?
Here they come. Not have bread, give them cake.
This infamous, utterly unfeeling remark of the Queen of France sent French men and women in a frenzy of anger and the greatest indignation against the monarchy.
The 18th century witnessed the emergence of the middle class and the professionals. The ideas of thinkers and philosophers such as John Locke, Jean-Jacques Rousseau, and Montesquieu gained immense popularity.
Ideas of a popular revolt against the monarchy spread to the countryside, culminating in the historic storming of the fortress prison of Bastille on the morning of
14 July 1789.
Down with the monarchy!
Down the despots!
Kill the nobles!
Fall of the old regime!
We want our rights! Abolish taxes!
We are born free and equal!
A national assembly of the members of the Third Estate came into being and drafted a historic constitution for France. Feudal privileges were abolished.
Thus, France waged a people's war which had a rippling effect, toppling aristocracies and thrones all over Europe.
Friends, did you know that the French poet Roger de Haye composed the patriotic song Marseillaise, so called because peasants from Marseillaise sang it for the first time as they marched into Paris. The Marseillaise is now the national anthem of France. On.
Oh,
Executed publicly on 21st Jan 1793. The Queen Mary Antoinette met with the same fate.
Guillotine invented this device to execute the guilty in France. This friend is a model of a guillotine consisting of two bolts and blade with which a person is beheaded.
Ladies and gentlemen, permit me to convey the meaning of these symbols widely used in France.
Change will use on slave. A broken chain stands for freedom from slavery.
A bundle of rods or faces. One rod can be broken easily, but strength lies in unity.
The up eye within the triangle radiating light. The all-seeing eye stands for knowledge. The rays of the sun will drive away the clouds of ignorance.
Center, symbol of royalty.
The snake biting its tail to form a ring.
Symbol of eternity. A ring has neither beginning nor end.
The red virgin cap. A cap worn by a slave on becoming free.
And the wind woman. Personification of the law. The law tablet signifies that the law is same for all. All are equal before it. And the colors of France: blue, white, and red.
How did the revolution affect world history? What has the world borrowed from the historic French Revolution?
Political clubs, including revolutionary clubs for women, came up all over Europe which was an inspiring one.
Slavery was abolished in French colonies.
Censorship was abolished. Dramas, street plays, songs, and festive processions became popular all over France, and these ideas spread to Europe.
Ladies and gentlemen, the most enduring and important legacy of the French Revolution were the ideas of liberty and democratic rights. In India, Tipu Sultan and Raja Ram Mohan Roy are two sterling examples of individuals who responded to the ideas from revolutionary France.